So, one of your central claims kind of relied on the fact that a lot of the ideology that we see coming out of Israel and Zionist ideology is directly tied to like Jewish religion and culture. But I think if you actually study Jewish community, it doesn't really seem to correspond to that. Most Jews in America are secular today. Certainly, in Israel, most Jews in Israel have like a degree of secularism. A third of Israeli Jews identify as Chilani. A third of them also identify as like traditional Masorati. So already the majority is not like who you're like describing. And you claim that, okay, just because they're secular doesn't mean they're not being influenced by their religious culture. But that doesn't really make sense either, because, you know, the origins of the Zionist movement, you know, they weren't just secular, they were also anti-religious. They did not like Judaism. They were trying to reinvent what Jewishness meant for another generation. So, and furthermore, I think, that also gets, like, support by the fact that a lot of the headlines that you quote when, like, oh, Israeli soldier kills or rapes a Palestinian woman, they were coming from, like, Israeli sources a lot of the time. You know, you quoted yourself the Times of Israel article. So clearly, like, not every Jewish person, like, that's, like, one of the most major newspapers, right? So clearly not every single person, like, or Israeli Jew. No, sure, but, like, we're talking, this is, like, one of the biggest newspapers in Israel, right? So, my question is, like, given all of this, don't you think, and, you know, given the history that, you know, most, like, Jews aren't even religious today, given the history of, like, the modern-day conflict of Israel-Palestine, that most Israeli Jews are growing up with, coming after the Second Intifada, where, you know, we can talk about, like, if, like, it's considered terrorism or if it's justified. That's not really the point. You know, people are growing up in a climate where they walk to a pizza shop and it gets blown up, right? That's, like, the culture. Don't you think it's a little dishonest for you to pretend like this is purely a religious conflict rather than something that actually is based on real security measures or real conflict because of, like, politics?
I mean, the kind of argument that you're advancing here is like someone who says, oh, I'm not racist because I have a black friend. Like, that's the kind of reasoning that you're using here. Like, the majority, let's accept some of these statistics that the majority of Israelis are not religious, okay? But what do you say to this statistic from Pew, that 79% of Israeli Jews believe that Jewish law should be state law? So that's 79%, or 29% believe that Jewish law should be state law. 79% of Israelis believe that Jews should get preferential treatment over non-Jews. So no one would agree that that's secularism or that's like democracy when one specific race is preferred over other races. That's what 80% of Jews in Israel actually believe. And that's what's implemented. Israel is not a secular state. Israel is considered an apartheid state. Many international authorities have declared that Israel is an apartheid state, including Human Rights Watch, Amnesty International, former President Jimmy Carter even famously has claimed this, that Israel is an apartheid state. Why? Because they have laws that prefer Jews over non-Jews. Judaism is state-funded. Yeshivas, which are the religious schools there, are state-funded. Kosher food is state-funded. Jewish holidays are national holidays. Shabbat, Saturdays are considered days where the public transportation is shut down in observance of Saturday. Non-Jews need to take the bus. Well, too bad. You know, it's Shabbos, so find some other way to get to your job or get to your house. It is a religious state. Okay, fine. Own up to that. Stop claiming that you're a democracy. Stop claiming that you're secular. Stop claiming that you don't care about religion. Stop. This is dishonest, right? If you want to be a Jewish state and implement Jewish law, stop claiming that you're the only democracy in the Middle East. Okay, so this is not, again, based on my opinion. These are facts. I can cite you all types of statistics from Pew, And getting into the violence, I cited the statistic that 50% of Israeli Jews want it to be exclusively the land of Jews, no Arabs. They want to completely clean Israel from all non-Jews. That's 50%. And where is that statistic coming from? That's coming from Western research agencies. So all of this is cited, all of this is well known, and I don't really see what you can dispute about it. The American Jews, are they secular, more secular? Yes, Ashkenazi Jews are more secular than those in Israel. But even within the so-called secular Jews, I think it was also 70%, 80% that believe that God gave Israel to the Jews. So how is that a secular belief to have if you believe that God gave you a particular piece of land? That sounds religious to me. And that's a religious belief that's at the center of this entire war and conflict. So yes, these passages, they do affect the wider Jewish culture. Not all Jews, because some Jews are aware of this history and they have been speaking out against it. I cited them in the presentation. Israel Shahak is an Israeli Jew. He's an Israeli Jew professor, and he's written extensively. He's the foremost expert on these types of critiques of Judaism. So there are Jews who are aware of this and are taking measures to fight back against it. Pretending like the problem doesn't exist is not helping anyone. Especially not Jews.
السلام عليكم. لا تنسوا الإعجاب بالفيديو والاشتراك في القناة تشجيعا لنا لنستمر بنشر المزيد إن شاء الله.